11, allow me to talk about God's promises to believers through the churches. In the book of Revelation, chapter 2 and 3, God tells us that there are 7 distinct churches. And each church has a purpose. The first church God talks about is the church in Ephesus. And he says that he knows them, and those who test, those who claim to be faithful and righteous, yet engage in perversion. And yet he says, there are those among them who overcome. He promises to give them the tree of life. That means eternal life. He goes ahead and talks about the church in Smyrna. He says, these are those who are devoted to the word, cling to the word, and endure persecution, even to the point of death. In their endurance, God promises to give them the crown of life, which is another dimension of everlasting life. So God has a purpose, and he speaks about the church in Pergamum, and he says, these are those who engage in the ways of Balak, the king who tried to curse the children of Israel through Prophet Balaam. But God sent a word that he is not man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should change his mind. So God promises that those who overcome the ways of Balak and of the Nicolaitans, he promises to give some of the hidden manna and to give them a new name written on a white stone known only to them. That is God's promise, the church in Pergamum. God goes ahead and speaks about the church in Thyatira. He says they are the faithful, obedient to his word, yet they tolerate the wickedness of Jezebel. If you recall, Jezebel was the wife of King Ahab, who was unscrupulous in her dealings, schemed and killed Naboth in order that the king would take his vineyard. He went ahead threatening Elijah, the prophet, and killing the prophets of God. So those who walk in her ways and tolerate her are sinful before God. Yet God promises that if we overcome them, then he will give them an iron scepter with which they will rule over the nations and over the people, casting them like pottery into pieces. God goes ahead and speaks about the fifth church, the church in Sardis, and he says that these are the lukewarm, those who are neither hot nor cold. They are seen to be alive yet dead, or seem to be dead yet alive. Amongst them, God says there are those who have not soiled their clothes, which means they have not engaged in any acts of perversion or sin. He promises to walk them alongside him dressed in white. And he promises even further to give them a lasting salvation, that he will never blot out their names from the book of life. Revelation chapter 20 verse 15 tells us that if anyone's name was not found in the book of life, then he will be cast into the lake of fire, which means hell. God goes ahead and speaks about the church in Philadelphia. And he says that he is a God who says and never relents. Whatever he shuts cannot be opened, and whatever he opens cannot be shut. He promises in Revelation chapter 3 and verse 8 that behold, he has placed before them an open door that no one can shut. If you are counted among them, then he promises that you will stand as a pillar in his courtyard, and you shall dwell in his house. At the book of Psalm 23 tells us that the Lord is our shepherd, and we should not want. He leads us by still waters. Let us lie in green pastures. He restores our soul to the glory and honor of his name. That even though we may walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we should fear no evil, because himself and his rod will comfort us. He says that he will anoint our head with oil, and our cup will run over even in the midst of our enemies. And forever we shall dwell in the house of the Lord. So this is the promise God is giving to the church in Philadelphia. He goes ahead and speaks about the church in Laodicea. And he says, these are the proud who claim that they are rich and they need of nothing. God wants them that they know not, because they are wretched, pitiful, poor, blind, and naked. He asks and reminds them to come to him so that he may give them pure gold to find in fire so that they may be rich, and to clothe them with white linen to cover their nakedness. They should come to him so that he may give them a salve to cover their eyes so that they may be able to see. And these are the promises of God. He says that if we endure, then will give us the spring of living water. Remember, in Matthew chapter 6, verse 35, he says, he's the bread of life. But he who comes to him will never hunger, and he who believes in him will never be thirsty. So God has good promises, and as you can see, he is giving promises alongside the role of the churches. So what is the role of the ministers of the Word of God? Whichever ministry you belong to, God has a purpose where you belong. Stick and cling to it, because they are promises, they are divine promises, and they are impacting words. We should remember, according to the scriptures, that God has given us free will. That everything is permissible, but everything may not be beneficial. And therefore, you should not allow yourself to be mastered by anything. Resist the devil and he shall flee. Say so in the book of James chapter 4 and verse 7. Draw near to him and he shall draw near to you. This is my word. I hope you are blessed. Like my video, click on the like, subscribe, and share. God shall bless you. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father and God, I come before your presence this moment to pray this solemn prayer. Ask you, Jehovah God, to sow a good seed upon your servants. Sow a good seed upon their minds, from the crowns of their head to the soles of their feet. Enable them to see, Almighty God, with your vision. Conceive with your insight. Lord, to hear with your sense of hearing. Because you are a good and solemn God, you shall give them a breakthrough in their endeavors. Pray this, trusting and believing, in the name of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. Be blessed.